Hello friends, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Poonam Chawla, an assistant professor with Maharaja Agrasen Institute of Management Studies in Rohini. Today, we are going to discuss on the interesting subject of forces influencing working and learning in context of learning and development. The learning outcomes associated with this module are factors influencing working and learning, followed by the summary of the module. Let us see what are the factors that influence working and learning. Number 1, competition for skilled employees. Second, attracting and retaining employees becomes a challenge. Funding for employee training and development. Less job security, limited opportunities for advancement, talent management and new technology. High performance models of work systems, the changing demographics, diversity of workforce, increased value placed on intangible assets and human capital, globalization issues, generational differences, economic cycles, focus on links to business strategy, customer service and quality emphasis, employee engagement, change and continuous learning. Let us discuss the first part, competition for skilled employees. There is huge competition for skilled employees and this competition will increase as the baby boomer generation will start to retire. As the occupational structure of the US economy has shifted, skill requirements have also changed. The demand for specific skills has been replaced by a need for cognitive skills, mathematical and verbal reasoning ability, and interpersonal skills which are concerned with working in teams or to interact with customers in a service economy. For example, these service customers could include your patients, your students, your vendors, your suppliers. Interpersonal skills are very important because in the service-oriented economy, employees must take responsibility for the final product or service. Variety and customization require employees to be creative and good problem solvers. Continuous innovation requires the ability to learn. Attracting and retaining employees has become a challenge. As competition is increasing for employees, attracting and retaining employees has become a strong challenge. To ensure that your organization remains a desirable place to work, it is necessary that employers provide learning opportunities and environment to the employees. Another important factor for development is that one should be able to use one's own skills and abilities on the job. This will help individuals in promotion and career advancement. Today, attracting and retaining an employee is a challenge as each sector has specific requirements. For example, childcare workforce is critical to provide high quality of childcare that benefits children's early development and learning. Funding for employee training and development is a concern for organizations. Even today, many organizations do not provide adequate funding for training and development, and that is a matter of concern. Though the need to provide for training and development in employees has increased, the resources to do so may not be available. In fact, funding for training and development is eliminated in times of financial uncertainty. Less job security. Employees in general have less or minimal job security today. People constantly hear that they can expect to have many different employers and even different careers during their work life. Today, employees are looking for employers who will provide them with opportunities to develop transferable skills. Limited opportunity for advancement. Most organizations generally have a flat organizational structure. This means that there is little room for promotion. Employees and organization need to embrace the idea that moving up is not the only way to be satisfied with one's work. An alternative is to create challenges for employees in their current position or a similar position. Staff can learn from their colleagues. For example, less experienced employees can learn from more experienced employees. Few employees can participate in external workshops and upon their return provide training to their colleagues. A skill inventory can be created and employees recognized as they work their way through that inventory. It is important to identify employees who are willing to develop their skills and seek promotion. For example, sales managers are encouraged to spend more time in operations where they can actually learn about product flow, delivery, and other technical processes, and it may help the sales manager later to take up a managerial position. This slide talks about talent management. Talent management means attracting, retaining, developing, and motivating skilled employees. Talent management is becoming important because of the changes in demand for jobs, skills, requirement, the anticipated retirement of the baby boomer generation, and the need to develop managerial talent with leadership skills. The results of surveys suggest that opportunities for career growth, learning and development, and the performance of exciting and challenging work are some of the most important factors in determining employee engagement and commitment to their present job or employer. New technology that involves the internet, e-commerce, reduced costs of working through new technology and alternative work arrangements which is supported by the internet. Internet is a global collection of computer networks that allow users to exchange data and information. Internet has also created a new business model of e-commerce in which business transactions and relationships can be conducted electronically. Use of internet has led to reduced costs and has changed the method of delivery of training, making training more realistic and giving employees the opportunity to choose where and when they will train themselves. Technology also have companies use alternative work arrangements, for example, telecommuting. A key training issue with alternative work arrangements is to prepare managers and employees to coordinate their efforts so that such work arrangements do not interfere with customer service or product quality. High performance models of work systems. Work teams involve employees with various skills who interact to assemble a product or a service. Cross-training here refers to training employees in a wide range of skills so that they can fill any of the roles needed to be performed on the team. New technology has brought changes in skill requirement and work roles. For example, we use robots and computers to automate the manufacturing process. Today, the technology allows the production of different products simply by reprogramming the computer. As a result, laborer, material handler, operator, assembler, and maintenance jobs may be merged into one position. Technology-based manufacturing requires employees to monitor equipment and troubleshoot problems with sophisticated equipment, share information with other employees, and understand the relationships among all components of the manufacturing process. Through technology, the information needed to improve customer service and product quality becomes more accessible to employees. This means that employees are expected to take more responsibility for satisfying the customer and determining how they perform their jobs. Work teams incorporate employees with variety of skills who interact to assemble a product or service. Cross-training refers to training of employees in a number of skills. Use of new technology and work designs needs to be supported by specific human resource management practices. Virtual teams refer to a group of individuals who work together from different geographic locations and depend upon communication technology such as email, fax, voice conferencing in order to collaborate. Changing demographics and diversity of the workforce. The aging population means that companies are employing a growing share of older workers who are playing their second innings. Older people want to work and they plan a working retirement. Despite myths to the contrary factor, worker performance and learning in most jobs is not adversely affected by aging. Older employees are willing and able to learn new technology. An emerging trend that is seen is for qualified older employees who ask to work part-time or for only a few months at a time as a means to transition to retirement, which is sometimes also called as phased retirement. Another source of workforce diversity is greater access to the workplace for people with disabilities. Because of this kind of diversity, it is unlikely that all employees will hold similar work values. Research cites that to maximize employee motivation and commitment towards the organizational goals, employees should be given the opportunity to grow. Employee engagement refers to the degree to which employees are involved in their work and strength of their commitment to their job and to the company. Change refers to the adoption of a new idea or behavior by a company. A learning organization has a culture of lifelong learning, enabling all employees to continually acquire and share knowledge. Let us discuss increased value placed on intangible assets and human capital. Human capital here refers to the sum of the attributes, life experiences, knowledge, inventiveness, energy, and enthusiasm that the company's employee invest in their work. Intellectual capital refers to the codified knowledge that exists in a company. Social capital refers to the relationships in that company. Customer capital refers to the value of relationships with persons or other organizations outside the company for accomplishing the goals of the organization. The value of intangible assets and human capital has three important implications. First, it has the focus on knowledge worker, and secondly, employee engagement, followed by an increased emphasis on adapting to change and continuous learning. Knowledge workers are employees who contribute to the company not through manual labor, but through what they know, perhaps about customers or a specialized body of knowledge. Globalization issue. Every business must be prepared to deal with the global economy. Global business expansion has been made easier by technology. The internet allows the data to exchange. Companies provide cross-cultural training to their global employees and their families, which prepare them to understand the culture and norms of the country to which they are being relocated and assist in their return to their home country once the assignment is finished. Some companies develop a leadership team to learn about the needs and the culture of the foreign countries, while at the same time providing valuable community services. Few organizations provide extensive coaching and assessment of managerial potential and provide regular feedback to keep employees focused on the things. Globalization also means that US companies may move job overseas. Offshoring refers to the process of moving jobs from country to other locations in the world. It is imminent to mention here that globalization is not limited to any particular sector of the economy, product or company size. Companies without international operations may buy or use goods that have been produced overseas, hire employees with diverse backgrounds or compete with foreign-owned companies operating within the nation. Generational differences. To successfully manage the diverse workforce, managers and employees must be trained to a new set of skills, which includes communicating effectively with employees from a wide variety of backgrounds, providing coaching to employees of various age groups, educational backgrounds and races, providing feedback to performance, which is free of values and stereotypes, training managers to recognize, understand and respond to generational differences, creating a working environment which promotes employees of all backgrounds to be creative and innovative. Economic cycles. Provide an opportunity for companies to take a closer look at training and development to identify those activities that are critical for supporting the business strategy as well as those mandated by law. The poor economy means more companies are downsizing their workforce, delaying plans for new operations and growth, and revising training and development and human resource budgets to cut unnecessary programs and costs. For example, in January 2009, more than 70,000 job cuts were announced, which impacted the employees from Pfizer, Texas Instruments, Home Depot, General Motors, so on and so forth. And newly retired employees are now returning to work out of necessity because of losses affecting their retirement assets. One estimate is that companies plan to cut their training budgets over 10% at the time of economic crisis. However, such economic times also provide an opportunity for organizations to take a closer look at training and development and identify those activities which are critical for supporting the business strategy of the company. They should provide an opportunity for companies to take a closer look at training and development to identify those activities that are critical to supporting the business strategy as well as those mandated by law. Focus on links to business strategy. Managers are begging to align training and development as a means to support company's business strategy. So, it is necessary that intangible assets and human capital play an important role in an organization's competitiveness. Managers are laying on the importance of training and development as a means to support a company's objective, that is, the plans for meeting broad goals such as profitability, market share and quality. Customer service and quality emphasis. Total quality management is a company-wide effort to continuously improve the way people, machines and system accomplish work. The Malcolm Baldrige National Quality Award standards were established to emphasize and recognize high quality and publicize strategies and expectations for quality. The ISO 9000 standards were developed by the International Organization for Standardization. These standards have been adopted as the national quality standards in nearly 100 countries. They are used in manufacturing, processing, servicing, printing, forestry, electronics, steel, computing, legal services, and financial services. Many companies are also using the Six Sigma process for monitoring and improving quality. Six Sigma is a process of measuring, analyzing, improving, and then controlling processes once they have been brought within the narrow Six Sigma quality tolerances or standards. Training is an important component of the process. Lean thinking involves doing more with less efforts, equipment, space and time, but providing customers with what they need and want. ISO 10015 is a quality management tool designed to ensure that training is linked to companies' needs and performance. Employee engagement. To benefit from employees' knowledge requires a management style that focuses on engaging employees. Employee engagement refers to the extent to which employees are fully involved in their work and the strength of their commitment to their job and company. Employees who are engaged in their work and committed to their organization give these companies a competitive advantage, including higher productivity, better customer service, and lower turnover. Although the type of questions asked in these surveys vary from firm to firm, research suggests that questions generally measure the themes such as pride in the company, satisfaction with the job, prospects for future growth, and opportunity to perform challenging work. You will probably realize employee engagement is influenced by human resource management practices, including training and development. A survey of senior-level human resource and learning professionals conducted by ASTD found that over 50% reported engagement, and it was affected by the frequency, quality, and number of workplace learning opportunities. Training and development gives employees an opportunity for personal growth. Companies measure employees' engagement levels with attitude or opinion surveys using training delivery methods that provide employees with the flexibility to manage their personal learning while balancing other work and non-work responsibilities, such as online learning, helps build employees' commitment to the organization. Change and continuous learning. Apart from acquiring and retaining knowledge workers, companies should be able to adapt to change. Change here refers to the adoption of a new idea or behavior by a company. Technological advancement, changes in the workforce, government regulations, globalization, and new competitors are the factors that require organizations to change. Change, I must say, is inevitable. In organizations, as products, companies, and entire industries are now experiencing shorter life cycles. A changing environment means that all employees follow the philosophy of learning. Now, a learning organization incorporates the culture of lifelong learning, enabling all employees to continuously acquire and share knowledge. Managers take an active role in identifying training needs and helping to ensure that employees use training in their work. Employees are encouraged to share knowledge information with other employees and peers across the company using email and internet. For a learning organization to be successful, teams of employees must collaborate to meet consumer needs. Managers need to empower employees to make decisions. That means they should delegate. This allows the company to continuously experiment and improve. As more companies become knowledge-based, they promote and capture learning at the employee, team, and company level. An example is Buckman Laboratories, which is known for its knowledge management practices. Buckman Labs develop and market specialty chemicals. Employees use laptops, computers, and technology so as to share information anywhere and anytime using the internet. The company rewards innovation and knowledge creation and exchange by including the sales of new products as part of employees' performance evaluation. Summary. Now let us summarize the module. Training creates a platform to develop the knowledge base of all employees. But many employers observe the development opportunities as an expense. Employees are absent from work while attending training sessions, which may delay the completion of assignment or projects. Training and development provides both the organization and the individual employee with benefits that make the cost and time a worthwhile investment. An employee who receives the necessary training is able to perform her job in a better manner. The employee becomes more aware of safety practices and proper procedures for performing the basic task. The training may also build the employee's confidence because now he will have stronger understanding of the industry and the responsibilities of his job. This confidence will help him to do better and think of newer ideas that can help him to excel. Continuous training keeps employees on the cutting edge of industry developments. Employees with access to training and development programs have the advantage over employees in other companies who are left untrained. The investment in training that a company makes highlights and shows the employees that they are being valued and also generates a sense of belongingness in them, thus creating a supportive workplace. Thank you. I hope you understood the module well.